गुड मॉर्निंग डियर चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज आवर प्रीवियस नॉलेज ऑफ आर्टिकल्स। बिफोर दिस वी हैव स्टडीड आर्टिकल्स फॉर फ्यू ईयर्स, बट आई जस्ट वॉन्ट यू ऑल टू रिवाइज सो दैट यू कम टू नो वेयर वी शुड यूज द करेक्ट आर्टिकल्स। ऑल्सो इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स और इफ यू हैव फॉरगॉटन सम पार्ट ऑफ इट, यू कैन डेफिनेटली रिकलेक्ट इट। ओके, सो लेट अस बिगिन विथ आर्टिकल्स। So basically articles are used before nouns or words that do the work of a noun in sentences. These words are actually adjectives which are used to define whether the noun is definite or indefinite. So articles are basically the words which are used before the noun or the word which acts as a noun. So, and they are used to define in a sentence whether the noun is definite or it is an indefinite noun. Now, articles can broadly be classified into two parts, that is indefinite and definite. Definite article comprises of the, and the indefinite articles are a and am. Now children, basically we have only three articles, a, am and the, out of which a and am are indefinite articles and the is the definite article. So about the article, because it is the definite article and only the is the definite article, so let us see where do we use the. The is used when we speak of a particular person, particular place or thing, or one already referred to, or something, that is, we have already referred to. Otherwise it is used to tell about or speak about the particular place, particular person or particular thing. So example is, the book you want is on the table. So this, we are talking about that particular book and on that particular table. So if it had be a book you want is on the table, so it might be that there are so many books on the table, and whichever book you want, so it refers to a general. But then when we say the, it is very specific, that the book, that is the book, particular book which you want is on that particular table. So it is said that the book you want is on the table. Okay, we also use the when a singular noun represents a class. That means when there is a noun which represents a class. So when we say cat, we do not really mean about a particular cat, but overall, in general, the cat family or all the cats, not even the cat family, but other cat, all the cats. So when we use the in such cases where we use the noun to represent a class. For example, the horse is a noble animal. So we are not talking about a particular horse, but we are talking in general about the horse. But then this one horse represents the entire horse community or entire class or entire breed of horse. Similarly, we can say the dog is a honest animal. The next example is, or the next condition wherein we use the article, is names of rivers, seas, islands, mountains, etc. The Americans, the Arabian Sea, the Himalayas, the Ganga, the Yamuna. So although we talk about a particular thing, but still when it is the name of the rivers, islands, mountains, etc., that time we use the article the. We also use the to name before the name of certain books, like the Vedas, the Bhagavad Gita, so the Ramayana, the Mahabharata. So we use the before the names of the certain books as well. We also use the before common nouns which refer to unique things. Earlier when we have said that in the second part, when a singular noun represents a class, so here also you can see that the singular noun is a common noun as well. So, but here it represents the class, and in this example or in this type, we are seeing that it represents a unique thing. Like the sky is blue. Again, sky is a common noun and it is referring the unique quality of sky, that it is blue. Like the sun rises in the east. So, the sun. So, these are the examples wherein the is used before the common noun, which refers to the unique thing. It is also used before a proper noun qualified by an adjective or a clause. So, example is the great Caesar. Now, this Caesar is not any Caesar, although Caesar is a proper noun, but then there are so many Caesars. Caesar is a noun. But then we are talking here about the great Caesar, that is the character in the Julius Caesar. So, here it is about the proper noun, but it gives the quality of Caesar, that he was the great king. So, the great Caesar. Then it is used before the clause also. The lamb that belonged to me. So, the lamb is a young man of a goat, and to specify that which lamb, the lamb that belonged to me. So, it is also used before a common noun, which is qualified, which gives us the quality as well, adjective or a clause. It is also used before superlatives. Now, when we use the verbs, there are 3 degrees of the verbs. So, it can be positive, comparative and superlative. So, before the superlative degrees also, the is used. Like the largest city, the longest sea, the shortest story. So, longest, shortest, largest. So, all these are the superlatives. So, it is used before that. It is also used before the ordinals. Ordinals is the number that we have, which indicates the position, you can say. So, it is the second chapter, the third story, or the first ranker. So, it is the position is called as the ordinal, which is referred to by the number. It is also used before an adjective when the noun is understood, when the noun is not clearly mentioned, but the noun is understood, and we use it before the adjective. The poor are always there. Now here the poor means the poor people. So the adjective poor is the adjective, it is not the noun. So, but it is here the noun should have been poor people. So here, but here the noun is not mentioned, it is hidden, it is understood. So before such adjectives also the is used. The is also used before a noun that gets the force of a superlative. Now in this sentence, children, example we have given, you have the jewel of all jewels. So, although here the directly superlative degree is not used, but jewel of a jewel means the best of the best people. So, the bestest of the best is referred to here. So, it is not exactly a superlative degree is used, but it gets a force of a superlative degree. So, in such cases also we use the. You have the jewel of all jewels. Then the is also used as an adverb with comparatives. Earlier we have seen the superlative degrees. Now we are going to see that it is also used before the comparative degrees. That is like good, better, best. So better is the comparative degree, best is the superlative degree, and good is the positive degree. So here the more the better. So better is a comparative degree. Whenever we make a comparison, like jaggery is better than sugar. So when there is a comparison between two things like sugar and jaggery, that time we use the comparative degree which is called as which here is better, and therefore it is referred to as more, the more the better. Okay, so it is used before the comparative degrees as well. Now children, remember, mostly sentences begin with the. Like whenever there is at the beginning of the sentence, it is usually with the, but not necessarily always it is with the. Sometimes it can be with a, it can be with an as well. But now where to use a and an, we are going to see in the next part, that is in the next slides. So let us proceed. Now these are the omission of the article. So here we are definitely not going to use the article before a proper noun. For example, earlier we have seen that we have used the article in the names of the rivers, islands, mountains. Although those are the proper nouns, still we have used it before the specific things. But generally, before a proper noun, the is not used. For example, the Delhi is the capital of the India is wrong. So before Delhi and before India, the should not be used. The Samir is a bad boy, or the Samir is a good boy. So here also the is not used. So in before the proper nouns, the is not used. Okay, before nouns used in a general sense, whenever nouns are used in a general sense, general sense means in general, when you want to speak about people, or if you want to speak about animals, about, or you want to speak about birds, or you want to speak about the monuments, the is not used. Whenever in general the nouns are used, that time it is not, the is not used. Example, man is a social animal. When we say man is a social animal, man means any man. It can be any of the person. So the is not used before the noun, which is used in general for the entire class. It is the is also not used before the names of materials. For example, gold is expensive. We should not say the gold is expensive. We should always say or write or speak gold is expensive. Writing the before gold or material noun is a wrong practice. Also, we should not use the before the abstract nouns used in a general sense. So if you see, in general sense, if it is a noun used or an abstract noun is used in general sense, then we are not going to use the. Like wisdom is a gift of heaven. So here also the wisdom is wrong English. So we are not going to use the before wisdom, because wisdom is a abstract noun which is used in a general sense. Okay children, so let us move ahead. Now we are going to see about the indefinite articles. The indefinite articles are a and an are indefinite articles. It refers to any person, place or thing, and it does not point to anything specific or particular. It is used when we refer to general. When we do not refer to something specific, we call it as a indefinite. In general, when we want to speak, when we want to say something about, then we use a and an article. Now, if you are in a hurry, you are writing your exam, and then you want your pen all of a sudden stops writing. So what do? You just ask to anyone, can you lend me a pen? Are you so very specific at that time that I want only a link pen, I want only a link blue ball pen? No, we are not specific about any pen, but we in general ask to our friends, whoever has any of the blue pen can give you the pen, you can borrow any of the pen. So when we are not specific, when we are want to speak something about a general thing, that time we use the article a and an. Out of that, when do we use a and when do we use an? So we are going to see that. So when we are not specific, that time we use ए. फॉर एग्जाम्पल अ डॉक्टर. अ डॉक्टर मीन्स एनी डॉक्टर. वेन वी आर वेरी सिक और वी आर गोइंग ऑन द रोड एंड वी कम अक्रॉस एनी एक्सीडेंट और अ फ्रेंड हैज मेट सम एन एक्सीडेंट दैट टाइम वॉट वी से वी जस्ट समन कॉल अ डॉक्टर दैट टाइम वी आर नॉट स्पेसिफिक दैट नो आई वॉन्ट ओनली दिस डॉक्टर. सो इट इज एनी डॉक्टर हु एवर इज अवेलेबल एट दैट मोमेंट बिकॉज इट इज एन एमरजेंसी. सो वेन वी आर नॉट स्पेसिफिक वेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट जनरल एनी दैट टाइम वी यूज ए. सो इट इज अ डॉक्टर. A is used before a word beginning with a consonant sound. Children, here it is very important to understand that it has to be a consonant sound, not a necessarily consonant. Why I'm stressing so much on the sound, we will come to know in the next examples. We use it before a consonant sound, that is a boy, a hammer. Okay, so here we can see boy B starts with an consonant B, hammer H is also a consonant. So we are saying a boy, a hammer. Now we also say a 1 rupee note. Give me a 1 rupee note. So although we are specific and also a is used in a singular thing because you want only one, so you are asking for a 1 rupee note. Now in spite of O beginning with a vowel, we are still using A because the O sound is the sound we pronounce is that of W, one. So we do not pronounce on. So we pronounce it as W. So it is a consonant sound and therefore we are using the article A. Also a university. University, the consonant sound is of Y because Y is pronounced as U and the sound of U is O. So if it become, if the university is pronounced as university, then it would have been correct, but we pronounce it as university and U is not the sound of vowel U, it is the sound of consonant Y and therefore we are going to use A before university. I hope it is clear, there is no confusion in this. So the sound what we produce is very very important. Okay, just let me tell you that the sound which we produce with the vowels, then we have vowels as A, E, I, O and U. Okay, just a minute. So A pronounce the sound as A, E pronounce as A, I pronounce the sound as E, O pronounces the sound as O and U pronounces the sound of O. So if we get these sounds, then and then only we are going to use the, you treat it as the sound of vowels, otherwise we are going to treat it as a sound of consonant. So the sound that is produced is very important and therefore we have to concentrate more on the sound rather than the vowels or the articles they begin with. Okay, let us move ahead. Now an is used for words beginning with a vowel sound. Again children, this word sound is very important. Example, an enemy, an orange. So here the enemy, we are the pronunciation of enemy is the pronunciation of sound E. The beginning is E. So E, E is the sound of the vowel E. So we are using an. Also orange, O is the sound which is produced by the vowel O. So again we are using an before that. So the consonants are making the sounds which the consonants make. So we are going to use an before them. Now we also use an before an R. Now here we can see that the word R begins with a consonant. It is not a vowel. But then H is silent and therefore we pronounce it as an R. So here the sound of H is not pronounced and therefore the sound of O is pronounced. So it is a vowel sound. H is silent and so we are using an. Similarly, an honest man. Here honest also we are not pronouncing H. We are only pronouncing the H is silent and we are pronouncing only the vowel sound of O. Therefore, we are using an honest man, although the first letter is a consonant, it is not a vowel. Okay, I hope it is clear. That is it, children, for articles. Thank you so much. I hope you have understood. If you have any doubts about articles, you can definitely get back to me. Okay, you can give me a message on my personal number. I'll try to explain it. Okay, thank you so much.